What do you mean you think you, or you said that you thought differently, and also you weren't being challenged. So what was that experience like for you? Can you be more specific?
Yeah, like in high school, my experience was like, I was the odd one out. I was always going against the grain because I feel like people my age were just there to socialize. They weren't really there to, you know, what school is for, to become educated. So, like, you know, I didn't, my teachers spoon-fed us information. You know, it was a lot of busy work. It was a lot of just get it done and over with, get your credit and get out. You know, and I had very few teachers that actually took account of, you know, the what that learning environment was going to be for me, how my mind was going to be able to function so I could grow as a person and as a student more so than just being passed and passed over, you know, to the next grade. When I went to college, because high school was so mundane, because I was able to pull couple all-nighters just to get my grade in and pass with a sufficient grade. When I went to college, it was so different. I feel like I barely made it in. And, I mean, I was going to a community college, so anybody could go to a community college. To me, that wasn't special. It wasn't like a special admission. Like, you know, the way the university was played out to me, it was a big dream. You know, you were selected because you had fulfilled requirements. You were that good enough to get in. And so I was already crushed with this idea of education going to a community college. And being there, to me, no one came from the same demographic. Like, no one had a similar last name. I'm Hispanic, Mexican descent. And I was going to school with a bunch of privileged kids who were, you know, there because their parents had paid their tuition. You know, everyone was there because they were expected to, not because they valued the education they were receiving, like I was. You know, I wasn't paying attention, but at the same time, I feel like because everyone else's demeanor was so just, I gotta get this done, and not because, you know, I'm getting it done because I care for myself, like that dissuaded me from staying in college. And that just made me, like, I just quit because it was too much for me. I didn't have anyone to talk to. I couldn't go back to my family and be like, I'm having a tough time because my family was uneducated. You know, they knew work, I knew work, and I mean, I knew college was, for me, it's how you build your credibility in society. It's how you get successful in life. But I didn't have anyone to turn to that was in my same shoes. And it was such a privilege to me, and I felt like such a failure that I wasn't able to keep up that first semester. You know, and that scared me, so I quit college. And eventually I just didn't know what I was going to do with myself. I didn't know if it was important enough. I didn't know if I was going to be able to afford it. So I stepped away from it. I ran away.
And yet you're starting in 2 weeks. Let's try again. So tell us, like, how you went from that place to wanting to go back and wanting to succeed and feeling like you could do it.
Feeling like I could. I think it was a number of things. Like, I was living at home. I had a crazy work schedule. I had to give a lot of myself to work to sustain a job. I had to give a lot of myself to school and balance out a couple of different classes. I had to fend for myself in a way, you know, I think everybody, a struggling college student does it. If you work, you go to school, you have to learn how to balance everything out, and you have to learn how to give yourself enough time and space to focus on the things that you need to get done. And because I never learned those good habits, I didn't incorporate that starting out. So I think it went from, it just took steps to learn how to balance myself out in my own personal time, you know, and really trying to figure out what it is I wanted to accomplish for myself school-wise. Like, I went in as a liberal arts major, hoping to go into arts writing, that type of field, thinking, because that's where my passions were. Now I'm, you know, going to start and be a psychology major. because I think my heart is in helping people. My heart is in knowing where and how people come from, like what those emotions are that can affect and influence, you know, somebody else's emotions. Like, what are the actions that we make every single day, or the choices that we make every single day? Like, where do those emotions come from and how can they affect people? And like, for me, when I realized that, was because I was working at a place where I had to really nurture not only my own feelings, but other people's feelings, and, you know, help them articulate that. Like, I think that's when I realized that I had a passion for it, I was good at it, and I could really learn about people and their emotions and their feelings and, you know, those effects. Like, I feel like that's what college, like, that's the field of study that was calling to me, and that I could really, really focus and do that. That's where I became re-inspired, was just seeing the effect that I had on people, that I could, you know, help them articulate those feelings. And so when I was able to do that with myself, I feel like that was my key. So why not go back and give someone else a key, give someone else a chance? And I feel like that's where my, what that decision was to change, was that I had to change things for me and give myself that goal and not look at it as, you know, what everyone else thinks about college, or, you know, not try to assimilate myself to other people. Like, that I had to remind myself that it was a goal for me and that it was okay to be there for me.